الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم من الأرض ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد. الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. آمين. The same subject of infaq fi sabilillah is continuing. The full preceding section, that is section 36 of Surah Al-Baqarah, that was also fully occupied by this discussion about infaq fi sabilillah. And this section 37th is also fully occupied by this discussion. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu anfiqu min tayyibati ma kasabtum. O you who believe, or O you who profess to believe, expend and spend in the way of Allah when good things that you have earned. Tayyibati ma kasabtum. وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ, or from which that we have brought forth from the earth for you. وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ, and don't aim at something which is bad from that. تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ, that you will spend it for the cause of Allah, for charity, for giving it to poor, something which is bad. وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ, and if some occasion arises and you need and somebody gives you that type of thing, you will not be able to accept it. You will not accept it yourself. Illa an tughmidu fih, unless you close your eyes on it. So it will be difficult to accept such a thing which you want to give to others. Wa'alamu anna Allaha ghaniyyun hamid. You should keep in mind that Allah is ghani. You are not giving to this poor person, you are giving to Allah. For the sake of Allah you are giving. You are giving it to Allah actually. So you should give the best, not the worst. He is ghani. Wallahu ghaniyyun hamid. He is self-sufficient, praiseworthy. Ash-shaytanu ya'idukum al-faqr. Shaitan threatens you, make you fear poverty. If you spend for the cause of Allah, you will become poor. You will have nothing. وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ, in addition, he enjoins upon you to indecency. وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ, on the contrary, Allah is promising with you مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ, forgiveness from him, وَفَضْلَى, and bounty. وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ, and Allah is all-embracing, knowing everything. يُوتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءَ, he gives the true wisdom to whomsoever he pleases. وَمَنْ يُوتَ الْحِكْمَةَ, and whosoever has been given and granted wisdom, the real wisdom, فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا, he has been given the biggest good, خَيْرِ كَثِيرٌ, وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, and only those who have real understanding, they get the admonition and they get the real advice. Now what does it mean here? You cannot spend the best of your wealth for the way of Allah unless you have the real wisdom. that everything that you have here is for this world. And this world is temporary. It's not everlasting. And whatever you are spending for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is for the other world. And that is lasting. بَلْ تُوْسَرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. Your real disease, your real mistake is that you prefer this world, the life of this world, while actually the life of the next world, the life of hereafter, that is much better and that is everlasting. So real wisdom is this. Whosoever has understood this point, not only that he professes that he believes in it, it is ingrained in his heart, it is there as a conviction. He has the real hikmah, he has the real wisdom. And then you know, the wisdom of all other things will also become apparent to him. His inner eyes will, so to say, be opened. يُوتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُوتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ نَفَقَةٍ أَوْ نَذَرْتُمْ مِنْ نَذْرٍ. And whatsoever you spend, any spending that you do, and every vow that you make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nazr, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُهُ. Allah knows it. Don't try to proclaim it loudly. Because if you are doing it for Allah, Allah knows it. Allah knows everything, even if it is in your mind and in your heart only. Because you know this sadaqah nafila, as far as zakah, that is the obligatory charity. As far as it is concerned, it is to be given openly to the government, Islamic State. It's not to be concealed or hid. It shouldn't be hidden. But sadaqat nafila, additional spending that you do for this pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that shouldn't be declared. If you declare, okay, at least you are giving something, at least it can be beneficial, it will be used somewhere. But the best thing is, you conceal it. You keep it a secret. And the wording that have appeared in one of the ahadith is that what your right hand spends, you let not your even your own left hand know it. You are spending with your right hand. Even your left hand shouldn't know that you have done it. That would be actually, that will have the privilege that this is exclusively for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there's no riya and no showing off in it. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ نَفَقَةٍ أَوْ نَذَرْتُمْ مِنْ نَذْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُهُ. Whatsoever you spend and whatsoever you owe to spend, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارٍ. But there will be no helpers for the wrongdoers, for the unjust. إِن تُبْدُوا الصَّدَقَاتِ فَنِعِمَّا هِيَ. If you disclose and proclaim your charity, well, this is also okay. At least you are giving something, at least some needs will be fulfilled by that. وَإِن تُخْفُوهَا وَتُوتُوهَا الْفُقَرَاءِ. And if you conceal it, if you keep it a secret and give away to the people who are needy, فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, that is much better for you. Because then actually there will be no doubt of riya and sum'a, that you wanted to show off, you wanted to get the praise of the people. If that is the case, you will have no reward on the Day of Judgment. That will carry no weight in the balance of the hereafter. وَيُكَفِّرُ عَنْكُمْ مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will acquit you of your evil deeds due to that sadaqah that you have made in secrecy. وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And whatever you are doing, Allah is well aware of it.